The gluteus medius gets a lot of love from trainers and therapists within the rehabilitation and training world, but it's actually one of the most misunderstood and mistrained muscles in the entire human body. And I know that's a bold claim, but we should dig into the details of what this muscle actually does and what the common training interventions are for it and why they often aren't really the best in many circumstances. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to split the glute med up into two main different types of fibers and sections. The front or anterior side of the pelvis has the first half of the glute med right here. The second half, posterior portion of the pelvis, has the fibers that run more on the back side of the pelvis. Now these fibers have different actions at different points in the gait cycle. As we strike the ground with our heel, the pelvis is in more of an externally rotated state on that side, like so. So it's more closed together here and more open at the top. And then we begin to move into an internally rotated state, like so, where the pelvis moves over a fixed foot on the ground and the pelvis moves into more internal rotation along with the femur. So you can see what happens there is the pelvis is going to open up more in the back and it's also going to close more up top right here as the sacrum bone moves in towards that innominate. So as we move into internal rotation, the anterior glute med or the anterior fibers of the gluteus medius here need to act to then drive the pelvis over the femur and assist in that internal rotation. In addition, the posterior glute med fibers back here need to eccentrically elongate for this to stretch out and open and for that pelvis to move over the femur. At the foot, we are now at mid-stance mechanics, meaning that we are striking the ground in external rotation and then going into more internal rotation coupled with pronation at the foot where the arch drops. So as we toe off in late stance, the pelvis goes back into external rotation. As we push off of the ball of our foot after mid stance, and then we transition our weight to the other side of our body. So traditionally people will look at someone who has weak hips or unstable hips and say, well, we just need to get your glute med stronger. And while that makes sense on the surface, what they will often do is prescribe something like a mini band lateral walk, where they will just strap a mini band around their knees or their ankles and then just have them walk from side to side. What they're training that glute med to do then in that exercise is to concentrically tighten or fire when the hip is in flexion, the knee is in flexion, and because they're walking sideways, they're going to strike the ground with the outside of their foot like so. But that doesn't make a whole lot of sense because we know that when the pelvis goes into external rotation and we need this thing to close off to allow us to push off in late stance, what we need is a reference of the forefoot and inner edge, because remember, we pronate and then resupinate off of the ball of the big toe and forefoot. So why would we want an outside foot reference with external rotation and hip and knee flexion when in toe off, we are in hip and knee extension? So that doesn't entirely add up, and it also doesn't train the anterior gluteus medius fibers, which in mid stance need to act to internally rotate that pelvis. And then the posterior glute med fibers are the ones that need to elongate. The first exercise I love to use to target the anterior glute med in mid stance mechanics is training it in a single leg banded step down activity. This is great because the pelvis is in the most internal rotation around 90 degrees of hip flexion. So we want to spend the most amount of time in 90 degrees of hip flexion because that's going to target the anterior glute med and it's going to eccentrically elongate the posterior glute med back here. So in this position, all you need to do is place a band around your knee so the band is pulling you outwards. That's going to provide a reference for you to keep your knee in, and that's going to target your adductor muscles as well as that anterior glute med. These two muscles work in unison in mid stance to help secure the pelvis over the femur and prevent it from going too far outwards to the side in that Trendelenburg-like pattern. So in this position, just make sure that you're really focusing on keeping your knee slightly in over your big toe and making sure that you're going nice and slow, and that's going to provide a nice burn in that adductor and also that outside hip anterior glute med region. If you don't have the strength to do this position, you can just take the box away and just keep that band around your knee and do a normal split squat, getting the sensation of your adductor and glute med working together. According to a study that was done measuring activity of the glute med, a side plank with hip abduction was very effective at targeting those posterior glute med fibers. I don't love this activity as much as others because there isn't a ground reference for the foot to mimic the gait cycle, but this is a really good way to get a sense of the posterior glute med working in hip and knee extension. A great position to get that ground reference I just mentioned, as well as train late stance mechanics, would be a rear foot elevated split squat position. This is great because it's going to naturally place more weight on your forefoot, and if you're holding a weight in the same side of the leg that is forward, you will have to find your balance somehow. And this is important because if you hold that weight on that side, you will want to prevent yourself from falling outwards to the side. So what you will do is you will naturally place more weight on the ball of your big toe. And that's really important because that mimics those toe-off mechanics in gait. I want to finish by saying there are no true bad exercises. Your pelvis isn't going to spontaneously combust if you do a couple of mini band side steps, but I think that there are better exercises depending on the intended goal of what you're trying to accomplish. I think it requires a deeper understanding of the mechanics that happen within human movement, but that's also going to result in better outcomes with our exercise selection.